अस्सलाम वालेकुम। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द वेन्स ऑफ द अपर लिप। सो देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ द वेन्स ऑफ अपर लिप, द डीप वेन्स एंड द सुपरफिशियल वेन्स। सुपरफिशियल वेन्स, द डीप वेन्स दे विल इंक्लूड द अल्नर वेन, the radial vein and the brachial vein, and these superficial veins they will include the basalic vein, the cephalic vein and the median antebrachial vein. These deep veins, they will accompany all the arteries of upper limb, and I have explained that in a separate video. And so today we will discuss these superficial veins on the and so this is the upper limb, this part is a forearm, this is the arm, this will be a forearm, and this will be the hand. So we will start. First of all, there will be a deep venous arch on the hand which will drain the blood from all the parts of the hand like this. From its lateral side will originate the will be the cephalic vein, on its medial side will be the basalic vein. So first of all we will see the cephalic vein. It will originate from the lateral part of this deep venous arch, and it will ascend on the anterior lateral aspect of this forearm and the arm like this. I am showing you. Till it will drain into the axillary vein terminal part. This will be axillary vein, and it will drain here in its terminal part. We will see some of its relations, like in the arm it will move between two muscles, the deltoid and the pectoralis major. Here it will also raise the costocoracoid membrane. This will be the costocoracoid membrane. Up before entering to axillary vein, it will pyrase the costocoracoid membrane. And this will be axillary vein. And this was the cephalic vein. And this was dorsal venous network. Now we will see the second vein, which is on the medial side, and it is a basalic vein. This will ascend on the medial side like this. And when it will reach the inferior third of forearm, it will become deep. Initially, it will move inside the fascia. So we will show it in a dotted line, and then it will enter the axillary vein. Now we will see its relation here. So it will be parallel to two structures. The one structure, which is the brachial artery, and the second one was the medial cutaneous nerve of arm. It will be parallel to two structure, and it will be deep here. And these two veins, they are connected in the cubital fossa by median cubital vein, which is an oblique vein. This will be, it will connect them both. This is occurring in the cubital fossa. This is median cubital vein. and the third vein, which was the median antebrachial vein, it will arise from the dorsum of thumb. From here it will arise and then it will move between these two veins. Its origin is very variable, but most commonly this is its pathway. And then in the forearm it will divide into two parts, the median basalic and the median cephalic. Now we will label it. First of all, this was the basalic vein. Basalic vein, and these two branches, first of all we will name it. This was a median antebrachial vein, median antebrachial, and it will divide into the median basalic and median cephalic. Median basalic, and this will be median cephalic. So this is whole the diagram of the superficial veins of the upper limb, and also the lymph nodes will accompany these two veins. We will also see that in a separate video. Thank you.